Our next speaker is Dr. Pushpalatha from the National Aquaculture Authority of Sri Lanka. Could you please start sharing your screen?
First of all, I thank to NACAC for giving me an opportunity to make the presentation. My topic today is approaches for sustainable culture-based fisheries in Sri Lankan reservoirs. In culture-based fisheries in Sri Lanka, there are more than 12,000 reservoirs and most of them are seasonal. Both seasonal and perennial reservoirs are used for culture-based fisheries. Culture-based fisheries is relatively low-cost activity. Mainly external input is stocking of seed. It involves simple technology and easily practiced by rural communities. These are the activities carried out for culture-based fisheries in Sri Lankan reservoirs: awareness creation, community mobilization, capacity building, preparation of development plans, introduction of fish seed rearing system, stocking of fish fingerlings and freshwater prawn post larvae, introduction and implementation of fisheries management measures, sustainable harvesting of fish, collection of data and record keeping, and use of data for planning and decision making. Awareness programs were carried out for farmers and officers at different levels, from community at village level, divisional and district, and up to the national level. For fishing communities, these were carried out by aquaculture extension officers of NACDA. Community are made aware of resource potential, roles and responsibilities of farmers in the management of resources, stocking of fish seeds, related laws and regulations, marketing, saving, credit facilities, etc. Then monthly meetings of the rural welfare societies were conducted to address villages. Extension officers conduct awareness program for government officers at divisional agriculture committee meetings, and the outcome of the divisional agriculture committee meeting were communicated to the district agriculture committee meeting by district aquaculture extension officer. Board meetings of NACDA and meetings with the secretaries of the relevant ministries, especially irrigation, agriculture, wildlife, defense, etc., were arranged to create awareness of officers at national level. PRA and RRA used for the social mobilization. PRA is a top-down approach. RRA is a bottom-up approach, which decision makers extract information from the local community. Therefore, mixed approaches of PRA and RRA was adopted for community mobilization in here. They consist of identifying issues related to fisheries community, empowering fisheries communities in decision-making process, establishment of rural fisheries organizations. For that, to identify the issues, problem tree analysis, Venn diagrams, seasonal calendars, resource map, focus group discussions, etc. were used here. With the facilitation of extension officer, community is able to prioritize the major issues and identify causes and effects. Those are the one example identified in culture-based fisheries in minor tanks here. For capacity building of fisher communities, residential technical training were conducted at aquaculture development centers of NACDA for all fishers in each reservoir. They include fish species identification, life cycle of fish, seed counting, and other technical matters were trained there. Executive members of the RFO were trained in simple account keeping, record keeping, finance management, etc. Training programs were conducted for members of rural fisheries organizations on leadership, personal career development, self-motivation, confidence development, team building also. In addition to that, TOT was also carried out for members of the RFO for planning and preparation of development for enterprise, or we call business plans too. With the assistance of extension officer, RFO members were motivated to prepare a plan for culture-based fisheries development, we call business plan. It consists of stocking plan, financial and management plans. Fish species to be stocked, stocking density to adopt, timing of stocking, source of fish seed and availability of fish seed, water level of reservoirs were considered for stocking plan. Financial plan indicated anticipated fish production, overall income, establishment of a revolving fund for sustained stocking, fund allocation for welfare activities also considered in financial plan. Management plan included management measures to be adopted, number of canoes, number of fishers, fishing days, type of fishing gears, and seasons and close areas. Those are considered, they are preparing their development plan. With the culture-based fisheries development in Sri Lanka, demand for fish fingering was increased. The government-owned fish breeding centers, which are main suppliers of fish fingerings, were unable to meet the demand. Therefore, fisher communities were encouraged to adopt alternative approaches to produce stocking materials. Ponds, cages, community-based seed rearing units, and pens were introduced there. Even the fisher community involved in rearing of fish fry successfully in ponds, cages, and pens, they have to depend on the aquaculture development centers to get fry. Therefore, fisher communities were also encouraged to breeding of fish. Now, land-based hatcheries and water-based hatcheries are operated by fisher communities successfully. They are breeding the tilapia water-based hatcheries as well as the carp varieties in land-based hatcheries. Introduced management measures are limiting fishing time, fixing landing sites, defining minimum permissible mesh size for gill nets for harvesting, surveillance to prevent unauthorized persons for fisheries, and protection of fish breeding grounds, establishing market channels, determining selling price of fish, and data collection and record keeping. Those are the managed measures are implemented by the communities. This is one of fixing time of the fishing time. In the morning, they are collecting harvest from the reservoirs, especially in perennial reservoirs. And in the evening, they lay in their nets. The benefits are easy monitoring and illegal fishing minimized, easy catch enumeration, and easy marketing due to that fixing the fishing time. Also, they limited the landing site. For example, the largest reservoir in Sri Lanka, Senanayaka Samudra. Before the culture-based fisheries introduced, there were 7 landing sites. After the introduction of CBF, it was reduced to up to 1 landing site. Also, shifting towards use of nets with the large mesh size. Government normally in the inland fisheries in Sri Lankan reservoirs, for perennial reservoirs, they use 3.5 inches. It means over 85 millimeter nets are used. After the introduction of culture-based fisheries to catch big size of carp, especially carps, they use large mesh size of gill nets. And also, fishers were involved in carrying out the surveillance of the reservoir to assist extension officers and police officers to protect fishing by unauthorized fishers and to detect the use of illegal fishing gears. The community's plan fish fingering stocking used, according to the stocking plan, which were prepared by themselves, stocking of fish and freshwater prawn post larvae were carried out. Nile tilapia, common carps, Indian and Chinese carps, these species are widely used for the culture-based fisheries. Regarding the harvesting of the Sri Lankan reservoirs, for the perennial reservoirs, harvesting is an year-round activity. Non-mechanized fiberglass outrigger canoes are used. Motorized boats are not permitted to use inland fisheries in Sri Lankan reservoirs. Only nylon gill nets are permitted to use in perennial reservoirs. But monofilaments are banned in use in perennial reservoirs here. And also, fishers lay nets in the evening and haul next day morning. For the seasonal reservoirs, harvesting is done at low level water level in the reservoirs. Start with partial harvesting and then carry out complete harvesting. For that, they use gill net and rag nets used for the harvesting of fish in the seasonal reservoirs. Under the management measures, the collect of harvest from all fishers by the rural fisheries organization, and they are keeping records. The most of benefits were get due to collection of harvest by the society. Illegal fishing also minimized and accurate catch data were there, and it is very easy to the marketing. Another management message is the establishment of the revolving fund. RFO are collecting collected 20 rupees from each kilogram of fish for revolving fund. These are to be used for regular stocking. In addition, revolving fund is also used to provide loans to members of the RFO and several other welfare activities also. In addition to these management measures, specific management strategies were applied. Establishment of barrier nets to prevent escape of sloughs, and also establishment of web-based data system and quality improvement of the post-harvest. Establishment of the barrier nets, it is basically important to protect the fish escaping from the reservoirs through sluice and sluice gate. Therefore, floating barrier nets were installed near the sluice gate and spillways of the reservoirs to prevent escape of stock fingering. This is the in front of the sluice they installed, and also they lay a circular shape floating net in front of the spillways. This is the net is the middle level and floats used and sinkers used to the bottom. Then to keep the records and to collect the data system, we established the web-based data system. During the initial stages, initial years of the introduction of cultivar-based fisheries, data were recorded in logbook systems by the fishers. Then it was a transformed into the computerized system. Most important aspect is data collection and data input and maintenance of database are entirely handled by the RFO members. Those are maintained by the RFO members. For this purpose, data entry operator were trained by NACDA. These data operators are the members of the fisheries society, fishermen are there. Now it was transferred to a web-based inland fisheries information system we call InFish. These data are used to decision making and planning. Then finally, we established the good market network, including retail and wholesale vendors, priority given to the customers who are coming to the landing sites. And also fish holding boxes were introduced to improve the quality of fish and freshwater prawns. New value-added products, three kind of products were developed in collaboration with the private sector enterprise as a market promotion strategy. Freshwater prawn mainly used for the export market. Women are also engaged in cultivar-based fisheries in Sri Lanka, especially for planning, seed production, fish feeding, stocking, harvesting, data collection, processing, decision making. All the entire process, women participation were there. Finally, for the sustainable cultivar-based fisheries, community mobilization and facilitation by extension officers and active participation of fishers for management and fishers involvement for decision making are important. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity to present myself.